Good morning, dear students. Very good morning to all of you. So today we are going to discuss the passive. So after a long gap, today we are having our online class. Hope you will join and we will do the activities together. It is very early in the morning. Till then, I hope as you are the students of class 10, so you will not miss this class particularly. So already we have discussed almost all the chapters of this Learn and Practice English Grammar book of class 10 Odia Medium English Grammar book, and only two chapters left, and within these 2 weeks we will discuss these two chapters quickly. Okay, Subhasri, good morning, and good morning to all others, those who are watching after this online class. So only two chapters left, the passive and a second one is direct indirect speech. Okay, quickly let me start from today's word. So today's word is arrogant. Arrogant, A-R-R-O-G-A-N-T. Arrogant means one who feels I am important and one who is very selfish, proud. So that sort of person is known as arrogant. And yes, very good. And its opposite, one who is very humble, modest, means who is very humble, sweet, and never feels or never become proud, that sort of person is the opposite. And in a sentence, we can say he is an arrogant person. He is an arrogant person, we can say. And now it's time to discuss the active passive voice. I have already made a video on active passive. So if you want, you can watch that video and you can understand what is the difference between active voice and passive voice. So in that video, I have only discussed and said the basic difference between active and passive voice. But here we are going to discuss how to convert active sentences into passive. Okay, so this is going to be a different one. And as you will surely get one or two questions from this chapter in your annual HSC examination. So this one is very, very important. Okay. Okay, Sunil, good morning. So this is very early in the morning, but still, as you are the students of class 10, so you should get up early. Okay, Asid, good morning. So after a long gap, it's really a pleasure to meet you here all, and you all are active also. I love you all. I love English teaching these classes. But due to the school timetable, it is not possible to do these classes now. Still then, I have decided to do these at least 2 days in a week at 6, Saturday and Sunday. And we will practice, because practice is what is much more important. Okay, so practice only will make you understand, and with practice you will grow, and everything will be remembered, because whatever we did in the last month, means January and February, that will vanish from your mind if we will not practice. Okay, I think I am right, and now it's time to start. So what are the things that we are going to discuss today? Number one, what is passive voice? Number two, three golden rules of passive voice. And number three, 15 points where and how to convert the active sentences into passive. And number four, we will do the activities. Okay, so these are the things that we are going to discuss today. So without any delay, let us start. So first point, your chapter is, this is 9th chapter. Sudipta, good morning. Very good morning to all of you. Thank you for joining. So today we are going to discuss the passive, that is your chapter number 9. So this is in your book 9th chapter. So what are the things that we are going to discuss here? Number 1, we will discuss what is passive voice and what is active voice, and number 2, 3 golden rules of passive voice, and then comes 15 points how and when generally we use passive voice and how to convert these active sentences into passive. And next, the last, we will do the activities. So we have to hurry, we have to do quickly, otherwise we cannot finish. Okay, so first point, how we are going to start. So people speak English all over the world. Suppose our sentence is, people speak English, all over the world. People speak English all over the world. So our sentence pattern is like this. Who speak English? If we will ask the question, who speak English? So people. So that means this is the subject. The answer of who is always the subject. Means this is the doer of the action, one who does the action. So this is subject and speak, this one is verb. Okay, so answer of who is subject, then what English is spoken. Yes, very good. So this one is object. The answer of what? Answer of the question what, and sometimes of also the answer of whom. So answer of these two questions is object. So what happens in active sentence? In active sentence, subject comes first. But in passive sentence, so what happens? There becomes, okay, good morning. So in passive sentence, what happens? So there is a cross. Cross means this object comes to the beginning and the subject goes to the end. So just like X. So English, and then there is a change in the verb pattern also. So English is spoken, then you write all over the world. English is spoken all over the world. English is spoken all over the world. So you can write the agent, that means using by people. Okay, so I hope you understand. In active sentence, subject comes first, and in passive sentence, the object comes first. Yes, very good, Asit. So you just see there is a cross mark. This is the rule of active and passive. Oliva, good morning. Okay, subject important, but in passive, yes. So whom we keep in the beginning? Whom we feel important, we keep that one in the beginning. So if subject is in the beginning position, that means subject is important and the sentence is active sentence. And how you are going to know? If you will start the sentence, or if you will start a question from the sentence using who in the beginning, then you will understand which one is the subject. And if the subject is not important, object is important. So that is passive sentence, and we have to bring stop. Okay, so we can omit by, because it is also understood English is spoken all over the world. So by phrase is optional here. But where we think that by phrase is essential, we have to use that. But sometimes by phrase is not that important. Here we can omit. And if we omit, the sentence, the meaning of the sentence is also clear. Okay, now let us move forward. So what are the three golden rules? Yes, by plus agent. Agent means the subject, agent means who does the work. So here, now let us know what are the three golden rules that you are going to remember about passive. Number one, Manisha, good morning. Okay, Sagarika, good morning. So number one rule is the object takes the position of the subject. This is the first rule of passive. So there are three basic rules that you have to follow while converting the active sentences into passive, or when you are going to recognize which one is an active sentence and which one is passive. Number one, what is the rule? The first rule says that in passive sentence, the object becomes the object takes the first position. The object takes the first position. This is the first rule. The object of the active sentence becomes the subject of the passive sentence. The object of the active sentence. Okay. So, object of active sentence becomes the subject of passive. This is rule number one. The object of active sentence becomes the subject of passive sentence. This is rule number one. Then what is rule number two? And number two, so first one talks about the subject and object position, and second one is the verb form. So always the passive sentence, they take the third form or en form or past participle form of the verb. Okay, and next thing, what is the third? That is the by phrase or by plus agent. If the subject is important, then that is used with the by phrase, and if that is not important, then that is not used. Okay, so these are the two things that you are going to remember. Okay, now let us write and start the 15 points about converting the active sentences into passive. So if you remember in class 9 book, in a table, it is clearly given the rules. So in class 9 book, if you remember, then you can find the rules that is given in page 12 of your English book. Here you will find how to convert the active sentences into passive. The rules are clearly given. But here, what we are going to do? Here we are going to do the sentences using these rules. Okay. So learning by doing is much more important. So we will do so many examples so that everything will be clear to you all. Okay, so for every rule we will have some examples. So total 15 rules are here that we are going to discuss today. So let us do one by one. I know you know so many rules and you have already done some of you, but still remember that practice will only make you perfect. So if you know tense, then only you can change the active voice into passive. So tense is much more important here. So if you do not know what is tense, what are different types and aspects of tense, so I have made videos for you all so that you can just no, just watching that videos, you can understand what is tense and how you are going to know and use which form of verb in which aspect and which tense. So what are the different types of tense and different aspects that you can know. So now let us convert these active sentences into passive using Now, before that, let me tell you how you are going to understand which one is an active sentence and which one is a passive sentence. So we will take some examples. Suppose we are living a hard life. We are living a hard life. So what is the type of sentence? We. So who are living a hard life? We are living a hard life. So this one is subject, and subject is in the beginning position. So the sentence is active sentence. Sentence is active sentence. If we write, his courage was admired. His courage was admired. So what is the type of sentence? Active or passive? His courage was admired by, suppose if we will write, by people. His courage. Now what was admired? What was admired? His courage was admired. So here object is in the beginning position. Object is in the beginning position. Yes. So that means this is passive sentence. Okay. Passive sentence. So another sentence, let me write. Suppose next sentence is, this matter will be discussed tomorrow. This matter will be discussed tomorrow. This matter will be discussed tomorrow. Now, what will be discussed tomorrow? What will be discussed tomorrow? So this matter will be discussed. So answer of what is object. And if the object remains in the first position, then what is the sentence? Then the sentence is, so this sentence is active or passive? Yes, Susri, good morning. Now answer this question. So when object remains in the beginning position, so that means the sentence is, yes, Asid. So here the sentence is passive. So in this way you are going to understand if the answer of who, that is subject, in the beginning position, so the sentence is active sentence. And if the object, answer of what or whom, in the beginning position, then the sentence is passive sentence. Okay. So in this way you are going to understand. Now let us convert some active sentences into passive. This is going to be very interesting for all of you. So first we will do, then you will say me the rules in which aspect of tense which rule is used. So first we will do the examples, then we will understand and discuss the rules. So in present simple, so we have to go from present. So number one is 12-15 points we are going to discuss here. 15 points. So out of 15 points, number one is simple present, or we can say present simple. So in present simple, how we are going to convert this sentence from active to passive? So in present simple, suppose our sentence is, children make a noise. Children make a noise. Now what is it, active sentence or passive sentence? Now you just ask, who makes noise? Who make noise? Or who makes noise? So children. So answer of who is, in simple way, in passive sentence, V3 comes after be verb such as, yes, Very good. So answer of who is subject, that is in the beginning position. So this sentence is active. Now let us convert it into passive. So here, what do children do? They do or they make. What do children make? A noise. So let the noise to the beginning. Okay. So this is the golden rule. This is the cross pattern of active and passive. So a noise. The sentence starts from a noise. A noise. Then we have to use is. Then the third form of the verb, that is made. Okay, is it clear now? A noise is made. Then you have to write by the children. By the children. Hope it is clear to all of you, whoever is watching. After this class, let me know whether it is clear or not. Okay, so this is one example, and next example we are going to write here. So father earns money for all. Father earns money for us. Okay, so father earns money. So who earns? Father earns. What does he earn? Money. Now take it to the beginning and father to the end. So money, then write is, then the third form of earns. So money is earned, E-A-R-N-E-D. So money is earned by father. Or we can write money is earned for us by father, by our father. Okay, so these are the two examples, and you will find some more examples in your book, in your grammar book, in this chapter. If you will read that will also help you to understand. Now, so if we will change this present into past, so what change will come here? So father, suppose, okay, let us write another sentence. So in past simple, how we are going to write the sentences? In past simple, suppose our sentence is, this is number 2. So addition invented gramophone. Okay, so you just see this sentence is in past simple, but previous sentence was in present simple. So if the sentence is in past simple, then the same formula. So take gramophone to the beginning and addition to the end. So gramophone and make G capital. So gramophone, then this is becomes past simple, object plus was where. Yes, very good. So gramophone was. So in present simple use is, am, are, and here in past simple was or were. Smriti, good morning. So gramophone was invented by addition. Okay, so another sentence. In every sentence we will discuss have two examples. So people killed the poisonous cobra. Suppose sentence is people killed the poisonous cobra. Okay, so if possible, you can write the passive ऑफ दिस सेंटेंस येस लेट मी सी हु कैन राइट आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू ऑल हु एवर इज प्रेजेंट हियर एंड दोज हु आर वॉचिंग आफ्टरवर्ड्स ट्राई टू राइट एवरीथिंग इन योर कॉपी सो दैट इट विल बी easier for you to learn and understand. Okay, so this is subject, verb, and this one is the object. Yes, good morning, Smriti. Just convert this active sentence into passive. So why this is active sentence? Because who killed? So answer of who is the subject and subject in the beginning position. That means this is active sentence. So we have to start the sentence the poisonous cobra. Yes, the poisonous cobra then was killed. The poisonous cobra was killed by people. You can use or you may not. You may use or you may not. So this here two examples we discussed, and then third one is present progressive. Listen, to get good marks and to answer the question from passive that is going to come in your exam, only rule is do the examples and activities. These are the two rules that will help you to answer the question that is going to come in your exam. Only and only do the examples and activities that is given in your English grammar book. So most of the times the questions come from your grammar book. Don't try to find and search for more examples from outside. Your book examples and the questions from your activity, those are much more important, and that will come in your exam and that is going to help you. So Sita is reading her book. So what will be the passive? So this is active because the subject means doer, who does the work, that is written in the beginning. So Sita is reading the book. So what will be the passive? Her book. So make it capital. So this is active and this is passive. Her book is, then her book is being, then the past participle read by Sita. Okay, so this is one sentence. And another, the mother is cooking food. Active, the mother is cooking. Mother is cooking food. Okay, so how you are going to convert this sentence? So take food to the beginning in passive. This is subject is cooking, verb, and this one is object, SVO. So take food to the beginning. So food is being, then make the past participle of cooking, cooked. Food is cooked, is being cooked by the mother. Okay, next. So this is present progressive. Yes, Smriti, very good. So this is present progressive. Now if we will convert this sentence or the next point, so this was point number 3. Now let us move to point number 4. So in point 4 only this present progressive becomes past progressive. So if we will not change the sentences, then it will be easier. So you just, Sita was reading, only single change will come. Sita was reading, so her book was being read. Her book was being read. Okay, we don't need to change the sentence also here if possible, because we are running out of time. So if we'll adjust here, then it will be easier, and I hope you can understand. So likewise, you just change this is to टू वॉच. सो माई द मदर वॉच कुकिंग फूड एंड हियर यू हैव टू चेंज वॉच. फूड वॉच बींग कुक्ड बाय द मदर. सो दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल्स. नाउ लेट अस मूव टू द फिफ्थ पॉइंट. सो वॉट इज द फिफ्थ वन. हियर वी हैव टू चेंज एंड यू हैव टू क्लीन द बोर्ड एंड वी हैव टू राइट इट अगेन. सो दिस इज प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट. ओके प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट. सो लेट अस हैव सम सेंटेंसेस एंड एग्जाम्पल्स. देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड वॉट चेंज कम्स इन पैसिव सेंटेंसेस इफ द टेंस इज प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट एंड वॉट चेंज कम्स इफ द सेंटेंस इज इन प्रोग्रेसिव परफेक्ट. प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट और पास्ट परफेक्ट. ओके सो ए कार हैज रन ओवर द डॉग और नोबडी हैज ओपन्ड दिस बॉक्स सो फार. सो नोबडी हैज ओपन्ड नोबडी हैज ओपन्ड दिस बॉक्स. सौम्या गुड मॉर्निंग. रविंद्र गुड मॉर्निंग. वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो नोबडी इज सब्जेक्ट हैज ओपन्ड वर्ब दिस बॉक्स ऑब्जेक्ट. नाउ टेक द क्रॉस फॉर्मूला एंड हियर द बॉक्स. नाउ व्हाट चेंज विल कम इन द वर्ब पैटर्न. हैज. सो हैज बीन. हियर यू हैव टू यूज द बी वर्ब दैट इज बीन and opened. Okay, you just see when we have had been, so generally the verb becomes ing, but that happens in active sentence. If the sentence is a passive one, so this one is the active sentence and this is passive. So here with had been, opened is used. It is only used in passive format. In active format, what happened? With has been, ing form of the verb is used. But in passive sentence, yes, the box has been opened by someone, by no one. Okay, so by anybody also we can write. The box has been opened by somebody or someone. We can use at the end. Now, if we will change this present and if we will change the number from 5 to 6 and here if we will write past, then what will happen? Where we will have a change? This had will become had. Okay. And also here we have had. So, nobody had opened the box and the box had. Nobody had opened this book. This box and nobody. Yes, very good, Asit. Yes, I am watching for that. You just see, this is nobody. Nobody means negative. So when we convert this box, had not been opened. Here we have to use not. So this box, this is a different type of sentence. You just try to understand. So nobody had opened this box. So we have to write this box had not been opened. Had not. We have to use not here because the sentence signifies the negativity. But if we will write the box had been opened, then the sentence becomes positive. That will not be the correct answer of this previous one. Okay. So in present perfect also we have to write not. I left that, sorry for that, but not is essential here. Now, next one is past perfect, gone, then comes. So, for present perfect progressive, 29 out of 30. Okay, very good, Soumya. Okay, so what I am saying, we have to discuss 15 points. We have discussed 6 points. Next is the 7th one. Now we have to write only one example because we don't have enough time. ओके सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग फॉर प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट प्रोग्रेसिव एंड फॉर पास्ट परफेक्ट प्रोग्रेसिव देयर इज नो पैसिव फॉर्म. इन नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल डिस्कस वेयर वी कैन नॉट कन्वर्ट द एक्टिव सेंटेंसेस इनटू पैसिव. देयर आर सम सेंटेंसेस व्हिच डू नॉट हैव एनी पैसिव sentence of its own, so that will we discuss in the next class. Now it's time to go for the seven. So passive with modals, the seventh one is passive with modal. This is very easy, only use B with the modal, use B and you will get the answer. As in your book, if you have your book, then page number 92, you can see here the letter will be typed soon. So if there is modal, how you are going to write? The teacher will teach a new lesson. Okay. So the teacher will teach the new lesson. So what will be its passive? The teacher will teach the new lesson. This is subject and here this is active voice. Will teach, this is verb. The new lesson, this is object. Okay, very good, Asit. So in passive, a new lesson, just use be with will. So a new lesson will be, then write the third form of the verb teach, T-A-U-G-H-T, taught. So a new lesson will be taught by the teacher. You can write by the teacher. Okay, so this is passive with modal. So a new lesson will be teacher. A new lesson will be taught by the teacher. Where this by form is not important, you can omit, otherwise you have to write. Then next, the eight. So eight one is passives with get or have. Okay, we will write the passives with by not necessary. Yes, so here by is not necessary, we can omit that. Okay, then comes passives with get or have. So what will be the sentence? Suppose sentence is, I shall get the barber to cut my hair. Okay, so what will be the answer? How you are going to write it? So the answer is, I shall get my hair. Only write down cut. Okay, so this is given in your book, you can understand that. The next formula is the passive used with a complement. Total 15 points that is given in your book. So you can do that. Okay, so next one, the passive used with complement. So this is the ninth point. So we are running out of time. We shall paint our house, or that is in your book. The students have selected Sushma Raut. The students have selected Purnima, monitor of the class. The students have selected Purnima. So how you are going to write it? So who was selected? So you have to write Purnima. So this is active sentence, this is passive. So Purnima, who is going to answer? Then have selected becomes has been selected monitor of the class. Okay, so what happened here? This Purnima, this is the complement used with a complement. So which one is the complement? Monitor. So when the passive is used with the complement, the object complement in the active sentence, the object complement in the active sentence becomes the subject complement of the passive voice, becomes the subject complement. Next, number 10. So I don't think that we can do the activity, but still let us try to complete. Yes, very good, Smriti. So next comes 10. So what is the next formula? So passive forms of the verbs having two objects. So passive, when we have two objects. So if in a sentence we have two objects, we can write the same active sentence in two forms. So for example, father gave me a pen. So this is one object, this is another object. So how you are going to write? This is active sentence in passive. So a pen was given to me. You can write this, or another type, I was given a pen. So in these both the types of sentences, both are correct. Okay, so quickly write it down. Only five formulas and very easy and rarely used. So these sentences are generally used, and the last types, they are not that much used. So let us discuss only, otherwise we cannot do the activities. Okay, so open your book. This is 11 passives with verbs reporting. So people say that elephants have good memories. If direct object comes first, then two is used. Yes, very good. So if direct object comes, then two is used. So people say that elephants have good memories. So we have to start the sentence. It is said that the elephants have good memories. In this way, you have to convert then passives with that clause. So for example, the earth moves round, it believed everybody. So we have to use it is believed. So for these type of sentences, means reporting type of sentences, generally used in newspaper. Listen, passive sentences have some limited use. Where it is used? When the object is important, when the work is important, who has done that is not important. So generally you will find passive sentences in newspaper. Then next, two plus infinitive. So the teacher made him stand up. He was made to stand up. Then next one, when they are in the beginning. If the sentence starts with there are a lot of windows to paint, to be painted. Next, the last one, sentence is in active form with passive meaning. The clothes need washing. The clothes need to be washed. So be plus the third form of the verb, that is the basic thing of this passive voice. So with this we have completed. So whatever sentences we wrote in the blackboard, those points are much more important. These are rarely used, so I have not written. Now let us do the activities. Activity 1, then activity 2, 3 and 4 we will try to finish today, and tomorrow we will do the next part, activity 5, 6, 7, 8, and in the next week, Saturday, Sunday, we will do the direct indirect speech, and with that this whole book will be covered and completed. Okay, now let us do activity 1. This is very easy. Just you have to write A for active voice and P for passive. Okay, so activity 1. Question number 1. Prakash killed a snake with a stick. Prakash killed a snake with a stick. Okay, so what is the type of sentence? Yes, so this, who killed? Prakash killed. So Prakash, the answer of who is subject here. So subject in the beginning means this is active sentence. Then question number 2, mother has made a sweet cake for me. Mother has made a sweet cake for me. So who has made? Mother has made. That means subject in the beginning. So that means again this one is active sentence. Then question number 3. Mr. Patnaik has been selected president. So Mr. Patnaik has been selected president of the Congress party. President of the Congress party. So what will be the type of sentence? Whom has the Congress party selected? So here Mr. Patnaik is the answer of whom, not who. Who selected? Congress party selected. But whom has this selected? Mr. Patnaik. So this sentence is a passive sentence, not active sentence. Then question number 4. R.N. Tagore wrote the Gitanjali. R.N. Tagore wrote the Gitanjali. Now who wrote? Yes, very good. So while answering, you can use the question number so that I can understand which question you are answering. So R.N. Tagore. So who wrote? Who means the answer of who? R.N. Tagore in the beginning. Subject in the beginning means active sentence. Yes, very good, Asit. Now whoever is writing. Okay, so the next one. Why was he beaten? You just see with was verb, what is used? Yes, very good. So with was, this must be ing. ing for past progressive. But here you see with was, the verb is the third form. So with was, with have been, has been, when the verb is en form instead of ing, that means this one is passive, not active. Then the last question, he must have finished his work by now. He must have, yes, he must have finished his work by now. Yes, so he means who must have, who is doing here. So this means this one is active. So here activity 1 is over. Now let us do activity 2, and you just try to answer the questions. Even if you do not know, then don't worry, because with passage of time you will be able to do the activities and you will able to do all the question answers that will come in your exam. So let us write activity 2. So use the correct form of the, put the form in the bracket into the correct passive form. Yes, 2 number 1. Question number 2 is active, you are saying. Okay, very good. Now let us do activity 2. Activity 2. So how you are going to answer? So question number 1 is, a car will dash next year if the savings increase. A car then will then dash next year. Only write down the answer. No need to write, Rabindra, now answer this question. Only write down the answer. No need to write the question, full question. Activity 2, a car will be, yes, very good. So if next year, if the savings increased, okay, so the a car will be, will be, this is modal, so will be, b-o-u-g-h-t, the third form of by verb. The third form of the verb b-u-y by is bought. Thousands of people dash in the earthquake. Thousands of people dash killed. Yes, were killed, very good. So thousands of people were killed in the earthquake, in the earthquake in Japan last year. This is past simple. In Japan last year. Okay, next question number 3. You just see what is the question. We cannot be dash. What cannot be dash? Must dash. What? You just see modal. What cannot? Then you have to use be verb. Be verb. So what cannot? What cannot be cured? Must be, okay, must be endured. Very good, Asit. Then question number 4. Fourth question is, he should dash for telling a lie. He should, the same passive, same modal is here. So he should, he should dash. He should be punished. Very good. He should be, because we have modal here. He should be punished. He should be punished for telling a lie. For telling a lie. He should be punished for telling a lie. Then the next one, let us write. The 4 is over. Then 5, we have already discussed this sentence English. English does speak all over the world. English, yes, is spoken. English is spoken all over the world. You can see here by phrase, not important, that's why not written. The road dash when I saw it last year. The road. So when I saw it last year, the road was being repaired. This present past progressive. So what you have to use here? You can use perfect and progressive both here. So the road was being. The road was being then repaired. The past participle form of the verb repair. Yes, had been repaired. Both are correct here. One is past. You can see that when this I saw, this is past simple, and another work was going on. You can write that, or you can use had been repaired. Okay, let me write the second one. Had been repaired. And then when I saw last year, when I saw last year, then BII, the seventh question, the accident might be caused due to the carelessness of the driver. BII, the accident might be caused, might be, yes, very good, might be caused due to the carelessness of the driver. Due to the carelessness of the driver. Okay, the next, the eighth one, people dash justice these days. People are denied. People dash justice these days. So we can write here these days means present progressive. So if we will use present progressive, then are being denied. Are denied. If we will present simple, if we will make present simple, then are denied. If present progressive, then are being denied. So people are being denied. These days you can make it present simple and present progressive also. His grandfather dash to have been a landlord. His, so IX is his grandfather. His grandfather dash to have been a landlord. To have been a landlord. So what will be the answer? Is said. His grandfather is said. Is said. People say this is reporting. We are discussing in 11 point reporting. I like live alone. The last one, I like yes, I like, then here you have to be live left alone. So here this is over, and activity 3-4, I hope we will discuss only the answers, and they will then we will wind up this class here. So what is the first one? So here is a letter written by father to her son. Yes, so generally letters and newspaper reports, those are written in passive sentences. So here it is given how you are going to report. So Rakesh, I understand that the annual day function of your school is going to be held on your school premises this evening. Then I have been told that the governor of our state has been invited to inaugurate the function and to give away the prizes to the winners. I know that you secured that the first position in your class in the last annual examination and also came first in the debate and essay competitions which were held at your school. You would certainly be awarded some prizes and medals for your merit and proficiency. I would have been very glad to see you receive prizes from the governor if I had been invited to the function and had been present there at such happy moments. However, enjoy yourself and stay happy at the function. More when we will meet. More means we will talk more when we will meet. Here the father is writing this letter to her son named Rakesh, and generally the sentences are written in passive, so it's not might have been caused. Okay, then the activity 4, here also there is a newspaper report. Generally in newspaper the sentences are written in passive voice. So let us see. So 50 houses in Khandagiri slum area in Bhubaneswar were burnt. Past simple. So were burnt to ashes last Sunday. You just see last Sunday is used. So past simple. So 10 children and 60 women again were burnt alive. All the belongings of the people were completely destroyed in the fire. About 200 people were rendered homeless and 80 people were hospitalized for treatment of their injury caused in the fire. Okay, next, how the houses first caught fire is still shrouded in mystery, means the reason is not known till now, and government's assistant for rehabilitation of these affected people is badly needed at this hour. So in this way you can write, and if I will write these things it will take time. I hope you understand. If you have any doubt then you can ask me next. So if your eyes are positive you will love the world, and if your tongue is positive the people in the world will love you. This is the thought of the day. So what is this? So if your eyes are positive, means if you will find positive everywhere then you will love the world. But if your tongue is positive, means your sentences are sweet and you will speak positively to everything in this world, then the people will start loving you. Okay Asit, so we did so many classes where you were absent, and today this is the deviation timetable, so many students could not join, and it's early also, but still I want to complete all the activities, that's why I did it. And very soon we will do the next class. I hope tomorrow we will have this left activities of this chapter we will do here at 6. Okay, so today Asit, then who was present? Soumya, yes, Smruti, then Sunil, Manisha,
सागरिका, शुभश्री, इज देयर एनी वन हुम आई लेफ्ट? ओके लेट मी राइट. लुक आई नो यू आर नॉट हियर बट स्टिल एज यू ऑलवेज जॉइन. ओके बाय, टेक केयर. Tomorrow at 6, we will do the next activities. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. And never stop watching the test classes that we did. The more you will attend and listen to those sentences, it will be remembered by you all. And all these chapters, I did the videos. You can watch that and try to understand. Write the names of your regular students. Okay, so there are so many students. Prabhasini, Sushri, another Subhasri is also here, and Sudipta, Shravani. Okay, and so many other students also. I don't Sanjay. Prabhu Kalyan, then who else, I don't remember. So these were my regular students, but due to this timing of school, we could not do or arrange such classes these days. But still, I have done so many videos, so if you want, you can watch that and try to help yourself. Bye, take care, have a nice day. These students like those teachers who remembers the names of the students. Yes, very good. Thank you for reminding me, my regular students, and all other students, whoever I know, I meet, I teach. I love everyone and I bless everyone, and let you get all the success in your life. Bye, take care, have a nice day.